So let's go on now to the solution box. So this is one that I mentioned early on, is that the part that most entrepreneurs kind of fall in love with. Like, this is the box we want to spend the most time. We want to stop building the rest of the canvas and go start prototyping or speccing or building the feature set. So this is the one that I actually stress people not spend a lot of time on yet. Because what we have right now are those top three problems that you think customers care about, but they are not really what necessarily customers think are important. And so what we really need to do is first go validate that before we bind ourselves to a particular solution. And so this is one where, for every one of those problems, I do kind of recommend, from a technical feasibility standpoint, to make sure that it is something you can build. You do have kind of an idea of what it is that you would build to service each of those problems, if that is what you would build. But we have to still go out there and test the problem first, and then come back and test the solutions that we have in mind before we commit ourselves to actually building the stuff all out and getting really detailed on, you know, what tools and what technology and what servers and all of those things that we would want to love to get into. So at this stage, in this example, for each of those problems, I list a single one-line statement of what the solution would be. And that's particularly why I made the solution box. I added the solution box here because I feel a lot of things derive out of the solution box. But I also feel like that's one that we can spend a lot of time. So I wanted to put it on there, but make it purposefully very small so that it was a place where people list things out, but don't kind of go overboard, don't have room to go overboard. So on the first problem, sharing is time consuming. We already had this technology for the instant no upload sharing process. And so that's what we list there as what we would use. For having no free time and lots of demands for content. So on the no free time part, we were looking for all kinds of ways to make that process easier. So an obvious thing was, if you look at what people spend a lot of time doing, is they're really just moving files around. They take files off the camera, they're putting them into a folder, then they're putting them on a server somewhere, they're uploading it. So what we wanted to do was cut down on those steps. So we had built in some iPhoto and folder integration. And sure enough, you know, we had plans of integrating into many other kinds of photo sharing apps like Picasa and all the others that were out there. But these were ones that were kind of low-hanging fruit that we wanted to start with. And so again, you don't have to build everything to start with. If you just define who your early adopters are, we felt like folders was the lowest common denominator. Everyone at a minimum had a folder on their computer, and so that was a place we could easily get started. On the lots of demand for content, there we had some ideas of building some better notification tools, because we ourselves had run into situations where we would push things out and then we would get these threatening, you know, phone calls saying, where are the pictures? And we would tell them, well, it was uploaded, but they never got the email or they never knew to go check. So just being able to build some smart notification was something we kind of envisioned, like, solving for that. So this is just a short list of potential features you would build. Now, if you have an existing product, I would encourage you to kind of look at it from the lens of what are those top three problems that you are solving for your customers today, and what are those top three features that address those problems, and can kind of look at it from that lens. So I'll give you a minute or so to jot down some of these solutions.